When I made the drive pulley for my 26-inch bandsaw, I cut the groove on that using my tilting rotor lift and a slot cutter. On this rotor lift, I can just tilt the whole rotor assembly, and that's how I got the angled size for that V-groove. But you might want to build that bandsaw, and you might not have a tilting rotor lift, so let's see how I can do that without the tilting rotor lift. So I'm going to make it this size, which is a bit smaller than the one on here. This one really is too big. I'm starting my circle with a backward scoring cut to avoid tear out on the bottom. Pretty clean on the bottom. A lot of cheap rotor bit sets come with a slot cutting bit like this, so I'm going to use that to do all the work. I just have to put that in the rotor now. The slot needs to be about 10 millimeters deep, so I'll just set my fence to that. And the plywood is 18 millimeters thick, so I want the center of the bit to be 9 millimeter above the base, like that. And to avoid things getting out of hand, I'm gonna put a side stop right here. The next thing I did last time is just to tilt my rotor lift by 20 degrees, but you don't have a tilting rotor lift. So instead, I need to incline my workpiece by 20 degrees. Now this V-belt is half an inch wide, or 12.7 millimeters, and this is 18 millimeters thick. So realistically, I want about 2.5 millimeters left on either side of the groove. So let's just check that with some scrap. I've got too much left here, so I'll raise the router a bit. That's about right. Now I'm worried that I don't have enough bearing surface on here and I might slip back a little bit. So I'm going to add a little bit more support down here, right there. That's what it sounds like when the rotor can't turn because the bit has hit the fence. That's looking good. And the belt doesn't bottom out in the pulley. Now before I do anything cutting out in the middle, I'm going to draw some concentric circles on here. That way I can re-establish the exact center later on, even if the middle is missing. Now if I was going to put this pulley on my bandsaw, I would cut the square hole in the middle of it and then carefully center it like I did this one. I talked about that in the video about making this wheel. But instead, I'll just try to put this pulley on my lathe. I want to get this hole exactly perpendicular in this workpiece. So by rotating the workpiece 180 degrees every few millimeters of drilling, that'll cancel out any angle error in a drill press table. I've also drilled a hole through the sides on here, and this is for clamping down on the shaft. Oh, nice. And now let's tighten that on the shaft a bit. So if I had a non-wood turning application where I needed to turn my lathe really slow, this is the way to do it. Now, in the past, I've also cut these grooves like that on the table saw just by making multiple cuts like that. And then, of course, to get the sides, I can just tilt the table saw, so it's a bit like a tilting router lift. But I don't recommend that procedure
because it's a little bit hair-raising. And for smaller pulleys, it makes more sense to make a temporary pulley to spin the shaft and then just lathe them with a chisel. And aside from bandsaws, I've also made pulleys like that for my apple grinders, because those need to run fairly slow, otherwise they throw chips all over the place.